For bank lending, its growth slowed in June. BSP data showed outstanding loans of Universal and Commercial Banks grew by 10.1% year-on-year that month. On a month-on-month seasonally adjusted basis, lending slightly expanded by 0.4%. That is, outstanding loans to residents also grew, but at a slower rate, while outstanding loans for production activities went up 8%. The growth in bank lending comes despite a prevailing high interest environment in the country.
Fintech giant GCash looks to leverage the expertise of its new investor, Mitsubishi UFJ Financial Group, or MUFG. The Japanese financial giant had acquired an 8% stake in GCash's parent firm. Mint President and CEO Martha Sazon said MUFG's investment allows it to tap the fast-growing digital financial market in the country, while Mint can tap the Japanese firm's clout. MUFG owns Home Credit in the Philippines and has a stake in Security Bank, among others. Sazon previously said that they plan to use the fresh investments from MUFG and Ayala Corp to further expand fintech's lending services. The wealth of the Philippines' riches taking a hit from a weak peso and a challenging economy in the first half of the year. According to Forbes magazine, the collective wealth of the country's 50 richest totaled just $80.8 billion, only slightly higher from last year's $80.4 billion. The C siblings of the SM Group empire remain the richest, with a total net worth of $13 billion, down from $14.4 billion last year. The usual suspects, including ports tycoon Enrique Razon Jr., as well as Manny Villar, Ramon Ang, Lucio Tan, and the Ayalas, who made up the top 10. Meanwhile, the Lopez family, headed by Federico Lopez, took the 46th spot with a net worth of $230 million. Lopez Holdings has a stake in ABS-CBN, the parent company of this news channel. Philippine House lawmakers continue their budget deliberations. On tap today, the proposed outlay for next year of energy-related agencies. Vivian Gulia is on the line for the details. Hi, Viv.
Hi, Denise. The Energy Regulatory Commission admitted before a House panel that its efforts to make electricity affordable for majority of Filipinos in the country are still inadequate, as this goal has yet to be achieved. ERC Chairperson Mona Lisa Dimalanta issued a statement during the House Committee on Appropriations deliberations on the proposed 2025 budget of the Department of Energy and the ERC. Saguit Partilist Representative Rodante Marcoleta raised the price of electricity in the country, which he said remains high, and inquired about government efforts to bring them down. The lawmaker zeroed in on the system loss charge passed on by distribution utilities to consumers. Dimalanta explained that technical system loss is a necessary part of the transmission process, but non-technical system loss, like silverages, are not beneficial to consumers. That is why the ERC has placed a cap to the recoverable rate of system loss for distribution utilities, which is currently at 5.5%. The regulatory body is also conducting an audit of fuel costs that are passed on by generators to consumers. To help bring down the cost of electricity, the ERC is undertaking the process of rate resets for deregulated entities, system operator, and distribution utilities. It is also studying the possibility of removing the value-added tax from system loss, lifeline rates, and senior citizen discount. Despite these efforts, Marcoleta pointed out that electricity rates remain high. Energy Secretary Rafael Lotilia explained that one way to bring down the price of electricity is to increase supply. He said the Department of Energy will continue to press on policies that will make it easier to put up new generation capacity to augment energy supply and increase competition, which are seen to drive electricity prices down. The proposed 2025 budget for the DOE is 3.085 billion pesos, 19% higher than its current budget. The ERC, meanwhile, has a proposed funding of 926 million pesos next year under the 2025 National Expenditure Program. This figure is higher than the current budget of 888 million pesos, but lower than the 1.5 billion pesos the regulatory body requested to the Department of Budget and Management. Denise, back to you.
Vivian Gulia with that report. Thanks, Viv.